Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup of People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Global outrage over the arrest of BDS Palestine coordinator Mahmoud Nawaja. Trump threatens deployment of the National Guard to Portland as federal forces are made to retreat. Argentinians march in the national capital, demand answers for Facundo Astudio's disappearance. Workers of Germany's Karstadt Sports protest mass layoffs and closure of branches. Activists across the world are demanding the release of Mahmoud Nawaja, general coordinator of the BDS National Committee in Palestine. 34-year-old Nawaja was arrested by Israeli forces in Ramallah in the occupied West Bank early morning on July 30th, Thursday. Nawaja has been a vocal opponent of the Israeli occupation and apartheid against the Palestinian people. He has also criticized Israel's proposed annexation of parts of the occupied West Bank as a crystallization of a 21st century apartheid. According to a statement issued by the BDS movement, scores of Israeli security personnel stormed Nawaja's home at around 3:30 a.m. on Thursday, blindfolded and handcuffed him in front of his family before taking him away. According to the last reports, even after 24 hours of his arrest, his whereabouts are still unknown. Nawaja was among 17 Palestinians arrested by the Israeli forces from different parts of the occupied Palestine on Thursday and Wednesday. Jamal Juma, one of Nawaja's colleagues in the BNC in Palestine, told reporters that Israel is attacking any form of resistance in Palestine. US President Donald Trump on Thursday threatened to deploy the National Guard to Portland if local and state authorities do not quell protests. His statement came after the city police took over the security of the city courthouse from federal law enforcement agencies. The courthouse was a place of intense violence on the part of federal forces on protesters on multiple occasions. Trump accused the state administration of not doing enough to disperse the nightly demonstration, calling the demonstrations a beehive of terrorists. The president also stated that the forces deployed by his administration will remain in the city in standby. This is despite the Oregon State Governor Kate Brown's insistence that the federal forces will be leaving the city. The governor also criticized Trump's attempts at violently cracking down on the protests. Recently, state and local officials have accused federal forces of unlawfully detaining protesters in Portland, with several reported instances of protesters taken away in unmarked vehicles. These detentions prompted an intensification of the ongoing anti-racism protests across the United States. 3 months after the disappearance of 22-year-old Facundo Astudio Castro, Argentinians mobilized in the Buenos Aires province demanding his safe return. Led by the Encounter Memory Truth and Justice Movement, or the EMVJ, the protesters carried out a march from the National Congress to the district government's office. Social movements, political parties, and human rights organizations also organized demonstrations in different cities. The protesters also raised slogans against the security minister of the Buenos Aires province, Sergio Berni. Facundo has been missing since April 30th, the day he left from his home in Pedro Luro for Bahia Blanca. There are witnesses who claim to have seen Facundo being arrested by the Buenos Aires police and taken in a police patrol car. There is also photo evidence in which Facundo is seen from behind, arrested by two officers. Contradicting statements by police officers involved raised widespread suspicion that the disappearance is a possible case of institutional violence. 3 months after his disappearance, a judicial investigation is far from ascertaining what happened. The federal justice system still does not have technical data on the location of the patrol car and the police officer's cell phones. Cristina Castro, Facundo's mother, and the human rights organization supporting the case reiterated their demand of removing the prosecutor Santiago Ulpiano Martinez from the case for allegedly diverting the investigation. On Thursday, hundreds of workers marched in the German capital Berlin protesting the closure of the Karstadt Sports Shop branch in the city. Workers are opposing plans announced by the management of the retail chain Galeria Karstadt Kaufhof, or the GKK, to lay off hundreds of employees across the country. Along with workers of Karstadt Sports, trade union activists from Verdi participated in the march on Thursday. According to reports, GKK management has decided to close 50 branches of its department stores chain by the end of the year. Such a move will directly oust around 5,000 employees and is likely to affect thousands of other jobs in logistics, sports, travel and food, as well as subcontractors such as cleaners and maintenance staff. The militant group Class Gegen Class accused the investor and GKK owner Rene Benko of mismanaging the retail chain in order to preserve only the most profitable parts of the business. Benko himself is estimated to own assets worth 5 billion euros or nearly 6 billion US dollars. Prior to the march, Worthy stated that the aim of the protest is to preserve as many jobs as possible. As per Worthy, since the employer has blocked any progress in the negotiation so far, protesters intend to march to the office of the parent group Signa in Berlin in order to address Benko directly. And this is all we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. De pie cantar que vamos a triunfar. Abajo.